So I decided to do a thing today, guys. This is my very first desert hike. It's beautiful. It's very red and green. And there's a train track right here. I just had to cross it a second ago. I thought that was really cool. So, I just came across a bridge, which is pretty cool looking, but it has a do not enter sign, so I can't go in there. Kind of sucks. I want to be able to see if it's like overlooking something, some water or something. I think it's overlooking the river because I've been walking by it, but it's cool because it's a wildlife habitat protection area. So that's kind of nice to know that they do that. It's really beautiful over there and they don't want anyone to mess it up. So I keep hearing this vibrating sound. At first I thought it was some kind of bugs out here, but back when it was opened up, it was only on my left-hand side, and now it's echoing off of the canyon over here to the right as well. So I wonder if a train is actually coming in one of these directions. This bridge is probably much better. This is awesome. It's completely enclosed. And it's just walking directly into these beautiful red rocks. And I was right. It's over going the river. It sounds beautiful. The way it echoes in here. Wow, this bridge, this river seems huge. Really isn't, but it feels huge. Wow. That creaking noise is when I step on these wood stickers. Some of them are shifting a little bit. Not in a bad way. They're not going anywhere. They've been there forever.
And young, free as the birds that fly with a weightless soul.
I'm gonna be really honest, I'm very skittish to movements and noises in the branches when I'm alone. I'm usually totally fine if I'm with someone, but for some reason I'm finding myself jumping at stupid shit.
Ran true inside these bones. We stood as steady as the stars in the woods, so happy hearted in the
woods. So guys, I found this, I mean it's a man-made waterfall it looks like, but I'm thinking of considering it to be the first real swimming hole. You could totally walk down these rocks and go around and get in there, or even climb down this way if you wanted to. I would want to. Looks real dirty though. I'm not gonna go get in there. I'm currently overlooking the waterfall right now. This is actually really scary for me. I'm not good with heights, but I'm feeling very adventurous. Holy shit! Okay, moving off of here.
I took off my glasses because I wanted to see it bright. I'm on a boulder now that's just overlooking the river. Which is really cool. I feel like I just had a very thick accent there for a second. But anyways, this is a very nice river. Don't ask me what river it is. I should have looked that up. I just didn't. Yeah, it's beautiful. So I got pissed at a bee because this, it's like a blue and yellow bee that was following me for the longest time. It was following me and it kept circling around me. And so I kept walking and kept walking, trying to ignore it. And it was like it was trying to intimidate me. It kept it kept flying around me and then kept like would fly in my face and then go around me again and fly in my face. And so I got to a point where I was like swatting at it. I was like, okay, stop. And it like would get worse and worse. It was getting more and more aggressive. So
I eventually literally started running down the trail, hoping that I could just like outrun this bee. And of course it always caught up to me. So I finally was like, had enough of it. I had gotten to the one swimming hole, so that was kind of cool. I didn't end up getting in, obviously, but I got to that at least. So I was like, okay, this was pretty productive. This was pretty good. So I decided to come back, and he still was freaking following me. So he eventually got close enough that I smacked him with my water bottle, and I didn't see him again. So I feel bad. I could have killed him. I may have killed him, but... Sorry, guys.